In the last lecture, we have discussed, establishing how to establish a problem is NP complete. In that connection, I have mentioned two problems, which is in the lineup of the undecidable problems concerning, Turing machines. For example, halting problem that is undecidable. So, given a Turing machine, of course, a standard deterministic Turing machine, and input string W. Whether M halts on W, that was the halting problem. We have observed that it is undecidable, and then there are several variants that we had discussed. In the similar lines, we have considered non-deterministic quantitative analogous problem that we have written the problem N naught, so and observed that it is NP complete. Okay, and then a variant N 1. Was mentioned, that means given a non-deterministic Turing machine, when you start that machine on an empty tape, either that will halt, I mean that accepts that halts in a given number of steps. So, that we have mentioned N 1, and I have also given certain hints to observe, I mean in fact, I have shown the function that you can you could have observed that it is a polynomial time reduction of N 0 to N 1 to understand that N 1 is NP complete. Now, this is a very nice classroom exercises, problems concerning Turing machines, but the power of this essentially we can in the sequence in this lineup, you know, I will introduce few more problems which to establish that they are NP complete, and in fact, we can target to observe the prove Cook's theorem in the classroom using this kind of basic techniques. So, certain variants of this N naught, N 1, these things will you can always take as classroom exercises and observe that they are NP complete. And now, what I will do, I will start with another problem called bounded tiling problem, because we have observed that tiling problem is undecidable. What do we consider now? A variant of that is essentially a finite space need to be filled by tiles given a tiling system. That is how we will take so called bounded tiling problem, and that we observe it is and we observe that problem is NP complete. Okay? So, and essentially what I will do here, now what are the sequence of problems that we are establishing, because to observe a problem is NP complete, what I said already established NP complete problem, if you can reduce that problem to the given problem, then you can observe that it is NP hard, and of course, you have to observe the given problem is in NP. So, these two conditions, that is how we have to we are pursuing actually. Okay. So, let me first state the problem called bounded tiling problem. As in the tiling problem, here you have a tiling system, let me say this, that quadruple D D naught H V, you know all these components, D a finite set of tiles. D naught is the initial tile that you will be fixing it in the left bottom corner of the space that you are filling, okay? And you have certain horizontal constraints H and vertical constraints V. Now, what in addition here is you will be given a number S, a positive number, okay? And what you are doing in case of bounded tiling problem, if you take the first quadrant, you are say let me put this way, you will be say the if the quadrant is like this, you will be choosing tiles in each position of this first quadrant which is unbounded. What now we do, we restrict ourselves to a finite portion, say this is 0, 1 and so on till, so 1, 2 and so on, say S minus S, suppose if you look at till S, if you look at then you see the tile this position is 0, 0, 0, 1, 2 and so on till S. Now, here this is an S by S square. So, our target is to fill this given portion. Now, what is the question concerning that? I give you a tiling system D and a positive number S, and I ask you whether there is an S by S tiling for the system D. That means, of course, you have to fix tiles from this set in this the portion of size S by S, that is what is essentially the target. Okay. Let me formally mention an S by S tiling by D, this is a function f from 0, 1 and so on S minus 1, because if you want to fill this corner, I will be talking about this point only, that is s minus 1, correct. So, what do you I have here? This is a function 0 1 to s minus 1 cross 0 1 to s minus 1, because each tile is represented by its this corner. So, this is 0 0 and this one is, you know, 0 s minus 1 0 position. So, the tile is represented by this corner, you know, in tiling, in tiling undecidability we have discussed the tiling. Okay. So, this is a function f from this square to d. That means, in each position in this square you have to assign a tile d which satisfies the these constraints of the system given to you. What is the what are the constraints? One, that this d naught should be in the left bottom corner, and if you are fixing two tiles, I mean f m n is a tile and f m plus 1 n is a tile which they are coming side by side horizontally, because you look at the position, this is m n position, this is m plus 1 n position. So, if they are coming side by, so these things should be satisfying horizontal constraint. Similarly, if you want to fix a tile above a tile, then they have to satisfy this vertical constraints here. So, that is what is essentially the bounded tiling problem. It is just a variant of the undecidable problem, tiling problem. What we observe here, this bounded tiling problem is NP complete. Okay? So, to observe this is NP complete, of course, now you can ask me, like, how do you represent this problem? Okay. So, given a system tiling system D and a number S, whether D has an S by S tiling, that is our problem, and one may write an appropriate coding for this, because it is a finite system. So, bracket D I am writing, whether you will be coding with 0 1s or whatever. Okay. So, I call this language T, tiling bounded tiling problem. So, the encoded system, the string bracket D at the rate on S, so the time the number of steps that you are allowed to you know perform is, say, for example, S number of here then S by S tiling, whether it is possible, that is what is the S is the parameter of the tiling size. So, the question is right. So, you collect all those strings if D has an S by S tiling. So, let us consider this language. Now, to observe that this T is NP complete, of course, you have to observe that T is in NP. Now, what you will do is, you have to give an appropriate polynomially balanced language T dash, that means, given a certificate, that means, if you are given a tiling, you have to cross check whether that is an S by S tiling or not, because S is a parameter given to you in the input. Now, you have to cross check all the tiles, whether they are satisfying the given constraints or whatever or not. And essentially, as we were doing, what you have to do, you have to write the appropriate language, polynomially balanced language T dash, and observe that T is in NP. You can take this as this portion as an exercise. Now, what I will demonstrate here is T is NP hard. That means what I will do, I will reduce a language which is already established as NP complete to this language T, so that, you know, I can say this is NP hard. Of course, I will reduce in polynomial time. Okay. In fact, I choose this language N 1 that we have discussed in the last lecture, that N 1 can be reduced to T in polynomial time. That is what is our my target here. Okay. So, that means, what I have to do? I give you a if you consider a string in n 1, whatever that f x that I give, that has to go to t and vice versa, such a reduction I have to give, and that reduction should be possible in polynomial time. Okay. So, now you take an arbitrary string x in 0 1 at the rate star. Of course, as I had mentioned, you can encode this tiling system as a sequence of zeros and ones. Okay. And thus, I am just writing here also 0 1 at the rate symbol, but of course, if you have some other symbols that you are using to encode this tiling system, then appropriate alphabet will come here. Okay. So, now you take a string x in 0 1 at the rates over this alphabet, and if it is not of the form bracket m at the rate 1 t, let me for some non deterministic machine m. If it is not of this form, then I simply give some string which cannot go in T. You see, as I had mentioned in the previous this thing, when we are work when I was giving hints for n 1. You see, when I am taking 1 here, that cannot be in t at all, because in t you see at least one at the rate symbol that we have. So, that this portion anyway is not in t at all. Okay. Now, if the string x is of a form bracket m 1 t at the rate 1 t for some non-deterministic m, what I would give you, I would give a tiling system this d m, because I am calling d subscript m, because we are constructing with respect to the given non-deterministic machine m d m, and I give you say 1 t plus 2. Okay. So, how this tiling size is coming, we will discuss now. Okay. If it is a non-deterministic machine, you simply give like this. Okay. Now, what is the tiling system? That is the question. What do we suggest is this, if non-deterministic machine is q sigma delta q naught, okay, then the tiling system, what do we do? You remember, we have created tiles when we are showing the tiling problem is undecidable. So, here also a similar manner, we create tiles and see whenever you have an S by S tiling, then the concerning the string is in language n 1 and vice versa. That is how we have to create to show this is a reduction. So, that means, what I have to observe here, x is in n 1 if and only if, you know, f x is in t. That means, whatever the tiling system we have created, that should have, you know, if I say 1 t plus 2, that much tiling should be there for this system, okay, and vice versa. Now, the tiling system what we are creating, I give you tiles, because let me first explain you the philosophy that how I will proceed. It is exactly the similar manner that we have considered for undecidability of tiling problem. We will have the tiles as the tape cells of your non-deterministic machine. Okay, that is how we have emphasized in that problem. And earlier, what was the situation? Whatever is the tape content that you are showing, and of course to start with the initial state, because on the blank tape you will be starting. Okay, and whatever is the non-deterministic machine M pursues, because earlier in that case, you know, there you are having a deterministic machine in case of a tiling problem. In this bounded tiling problem, I am having a non-deterministic machine. Whatever is the non-deterministic machine that it pursues to halt, you know, within the given number of steps, I will try to have here an S by S tiling and with an appropriate S. Okay. So, what are the tiles over there? The tiles are essentially the cells, tape cells in the tiling problem. Here also, what do I do? What are the cell content with respect to that? Each cell will be seen as a tile, and I define tiles appropriately, and each of these rows, what is the information of the tape that will be propagated over the computation of M, or the computation of M to fill an appropriate size, you know, of size S. Okay. So, the same philosophy will continue here. So, in that connection, I will consider tiles of this form, the first type, for each symbol A in sigma, and 0, I mean for each k up to t, because t is given to us, because we are given m and t, right. So, these two parameters are with us. Okay. So, I consider if the I will have a tile for which, you know, which can be fixed with the information a k, and the same information will be there in the next level also, okay, next row also. That is how, that means these are the tiles which can be used to fix the current information in a particular cell if it is not changing. For example, I have here say blank, and this is the 0th row, because so, you know, this is 0, 1 like this, right. So, that means, what I am trying to say, this is the situation with this cell, and if there is no change in the second what is called the configuration or the tape content, then I will have the same this thing, but now the situation is the configuration, this is the first second configuration. So, I am representing it this by this. So, that means, this tile now, you know, the horizontal vertical constraints will also be shown by this. So, for this tile when a k is the information at this, and for this tile you can have a k plus 1 as the information when there is no change. So, what is the difference? Earlier you would have considered just tiles, the information need to be continued. Maybe I would have written this way, right. So, what I am saying is here, so instead of writing inside, okay, I am just writing outside. Okay. So, when the information, there is no change in the information from the previous configuration to this in a particular cell, that can be this type of tiles can be used. Okay. And then regarding this transition, concerning each transition, you know, the respective things need to be sort of considered. So, the transition will in a particular cell will be earlier say q naught blank, and now when you are applying a transition on this, because the state component is here. So, the state component is an additional component to the particular concerning tile. So, look at, if you have a transition p a q b, right, because it is a non deterministic machine, this is a delta transition set. Okay. So, for a state p and q, that can be a halting state for symbols for symbols in sigma a b. If I have this transition, what do I say? I will consider this kind of tiles. So, p a k, you know, which can be transformed to, because b is getting printed. So, changing to the state q, you are in the current cell only, but you know, because of this transition, you will be moving from one configuration to its next configuration. That means, in the computation one step that you have progressed. So, this k, the parameter as I had mentioned, this gives the progression of your computation. So, if you are in the kth configuration, the k plus 1 configuration, you will have the current cell q and the current tape content is b. Okay. This kind of thing I will consider for all the possibilities, okay, up to the t number of steps. So, the for all k 0 less than or equal to k less than t, okay, concerning this this transition. Now, if the transition is taking a right move as earlier in case of tiling problem, we are considering this, look at here. So, p a k, that means the tape content a from in the state p in the kth computation, the kth step, since it is changing to the state q and taking a right move, the current cell tape content is a only in the next step. Of course, I will have a now a horizontal constraint here, which this can be fixed, you know, next to, because this q is going out and q is coming in, so that you know the current cell can be updated by the state q, right. So, this kind of transition, you know, whenever there is a right transition, right move, then we consider this kind of symbol. It is exactly what we have discussed in case of tiling problem, but what is the difference here? The difference is the time parameter, the step parameter that we are including in this. That means, if you are in k step, if a particular configuration is there in k plus 1 step in that particular cell, what is getting updated there. Okay. So, this is the business that we are updating here, and now I consider such tiles which can be fixed up to the t steps. So, for all k 0 less than or equal to k less than t, because I am allowed to go for t number of steps with m. So, that is why up to t we are considering. Similarly, for left transition, a transition which takes left move, okay, p a q l, if this is the transition, like as earlier, only parameter is this step parameter that we are putting it here. So, you are, since you are changing to the state q, I am taking this can be fixed to right of a cell which is of this form. Okay. So, if the current content of this cell is b k in kth step, if it is b, now the current cell content is still b in k plus 1 step, whereas the current state, the state component will show up in this particular cell. So, in this cell the reading and writing head will be there. So, representing that, we are constructing this kind of what is called a tile. Okay. Now, the thing is, when I am trying to make an SBS tiling, I will go up to t steps. So, in between, say for example, I get a halting state. Since I am targeting to give an SBS tiling for some s, because this Turing machine you know, when you are starting on the blank tape, it will halt within t steps. Within t steps means, you know, the number of configurations that you get here are within that, you know, t plus 1 number. Okay. Now, the point is how many steps that can be, you know, if t is 10, this must be halting in 5 steps, it may be in 6 steps, it may be in 7 steps, whatever it is. For example, you know, if this is 10, all right, so, okay, so this is till this point. Now, it is we are allowed, you know, if the machine will halt within 10 steps. So, it may be after 3 steps, it may be after 4 steps. For example, if it is halting after 4 steps. Now, we should still have a propagation of these configurations, you know, that computation should be shown up, so that you will have an appropriate tiling in any case. So, what we give here, because see the propagation is possible with respect to transition only, because this is one configuration. How do I get an extra configuration if there is a transition, right? So, the application of some element in delta. Similarly, if I have this configuration, I can go to this if I have some what is called transition. Okay? Once I get a halting state, now no transition is applicable, you know that. Now, how do I then fill all this portion? I cannot fill, right? If I just rely on the transitions only. Now, what do? If it is a halting configuration, I allow you to give the propagation of this tape cell, I mean what is called a tiling with halting configuration up to a certain mark. What is that mark that we will look at? Okay? Fine. So, we will look at an example and then evaluate like how many such tiles need to be given. What this exactly indicates? If you are having the tape content k in the k step with a halting state h, you are allowed to propagate this what is called computation. Of course, you are not going to get any change. The same configuration that I would be writing so many times, a fixed number of times to propagate this tiling up to you know, some s, whatever that we are targeting to show. Okay. Intention of this tile is clear. Okay. And now, you look at left bottom corner, this is how, this is a special tile that we should have, because in the left bottom corner is a blank cell with the current initial state q naught, that is, you know, the zeroth configuration, and I say that after first step I may get 1 and so on. Okay. So, this kind of initial tile you should have, and then to fix in the first this thing, if you have q naught like this, the next cell blank and so on, the respective number of blank cells, because this will be seen as tiling to right later on. So, that way these are all blank cells you would require. So, blank in the 0th this thing, so blank 0, left to right, this is the horizontal constraints, left side is a blank cell, right side also blank cell and so on. Of course, since we are targeting to have this bounded tiling, the last tile here, the left to that, you know, I will have blank cell, and what is right to that? I am not giving any constraint here, right. So, this kind of tile with 0th position I will be fixing. Okay? So, this kind of tile we may consider. Fine. Now, let us just look at an example to talk about how much should be the s with respect to t. Okay. Now, if I consider a Turing machine just behaves like this, that means how do I give? So, this non-deterministic machine, okay, I will just give in a deterministic manner, does not matter. Assume that when you start it in q naught, it will go to, you know, state say q 1 and take a right move, and in q 1 when it reads blank, it takes a right move and come to q naught. Okay? And assume this does, okay, let me just, because I wanted to halt it finite number of steps, say q 1, and it takes say another right move in q 2 and another move say in q 3. Okay? It is not changing any tape content, so the blank is that, and in q 3 in blank cell it takes another right move and halt, for example, takes a right move. Okay? Let me consider a Turing machine behaves like this, that means it simply takes, you know, so many right moves and then halts, finite number of right moves. So, what is my, you know, computation in q naught? You start with a blank tape, in the next step, it will go to Q1 and takes a right move. All right. So, that means that is the next configuration. And in the next step, it goes to Q2 and takes another right move, so that you know this is the configuration. Then the next step, it will go to Q3 and takes another right move. Okay. So, this is the next configuration. And then right. So, now it suppose it halts. Right. So, it takes a right move and halt suppose. Okay. It takes a right move and halt. So, how many steps it took? Step 1, this is step 2, step 3, step 4 steps. Say for example, someone is telling me that this halts in say 6 steps. Now, what exactly I wanted to look at here is, see this blank, the state component Q0. This is in the 0th step. Okay. So, other cells are blank in the 0th cell. So, let me put 0 like this. And in the next configuration, what I have here? So, the tape content is blank, that is not getting changed. So, it is taking a right move. So, this Q1 goes here, this is blank. Now, this is you know the first after you know in the first step. So, I write 1 here. Now, 1 here and then this propagates, this is the situation and so on. Now, in the next step, this is the tape cell content is this. In the k step, I have 1 here, in the k plus 1 step that is 2. Okay. And then this is again this Q1 in the blank, and you read it takes a right move and goes to Q2. So, since it is taking a right move, the tape content is this. Okay, in the next step, but here you have Q2 this blank in the second step. All right. So, and of course, here is a blank in 0 step and then this will be blank in the first step and there is no change, blank in the second step likewise we have. And then you will have here say Q3 blank in the third step, right. So, likewise you have the propagation of tiles that we wanted to fix, and then in Q3 I will get say halting in the next stage. So, this is a halting the tape content blank in the fourth step. Since someone told me that this halts in 6 steps, so the T for me is 6. So, and since it is halting in 4 steps, I know this much tiling is possible. But since we are targeting with respect to T and it may be 3 steps, it may be 4 steps, it may be 5 steps, what I should have? I should have a mechanism of propagating these tiles up to you know some number with respect to that T. All right. Thus, what we suggest is you have tiles with a halting state that you can propagate up to so many. Okay. Now, you can ask me, what is the minimum number that I should fix for this tiling, what is that size? Now, you look at here, if it is halting in exactly 4 steps, you look at this will be the first row, okay, that is 0, and this is coming in 1, this is coming in 2, this is coming in 3, this is coming in 4, all right, this is coming in 4. Now, since it is halting, maybe this is the best that you can stop. So, this is halting in T equal to 4 steps. Now, what is the tiling that we have here? Look at this size of this. What is the size of this? That is you know 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all right. So, within 4 steps. Okay. So, this configuration is fixed here. And then this configuration is coming here 2, 3, 4. So, at this point this will halt. So, within you know this we have 4 steps here. So, this much tiling can be done here. Now, what is the appropriate what is this tiling here? So, how many cells that we have filled here? So, 0 1 1 1 2 2 and till this is 4. So, if I say if it halts in 4 steps, if it halts in 4 steps. So, we have a thing like this, the halting configuration has come here. Now, for example, if you take anything t little more than any s which is little more than this much, because within this many steps this will halt, within this many steps this will halt. So, even if it halts, if I take little more than this, I can actually continue to propagate through halting state and make appropriate tiling. That is what is the target. Now, what do I choose here is S is equal to t plus 2. Okay. So, now if you take S is equal to t plus 2, this is an optimal number. You can look at why this is, you can look at why this is, because after the halting configuration if you come, if you get, you can propagate at least one more time, and thereafter you will be, if you want, if you required, you can continue. So, this gives you at least one more time I can propagate with the halting this thing. Once I realize that okay, I am started propagating with halting only, that means this has come to halting state. For example, if I just fix at this boundary, if this is not halting state, suppose if I say I wanted to just have only say S is equal to 5, then this is what is 5 by 5 tiling, okay, because 0 1 2 3 4, now this entire thing is filled. Suppose this is not halting state, then what will be the situation? You have got already S by S tiling, S is equal to 5. Now, I wanted to leave at least one more this thing blank, if I do not get within this many steps halting state. That means, say for example, here instead of H, if I have say for example, some Q, some state Q, if I just declare this much only, that means, S is equal to t plus 1. Because this is 5 by 5 tiling, correct? 5 by 5 tiling is from 0 1 2 4 cross 0 1 2 4. If I just take S by S tiling with S is equal to 5 in this case, even if it is not halting state, then you have got the tiling, complete tiling. So, what I wanted to look at, if I take one more, that means t is equal to S is equal to t plus 2, within t steps, if it is you know, within t steps, if it is halting with this, then what we are going to have, once I realize that a halting state is there, then I am able to propagate it here, okay, right. And if it is not halting, what do you see, if it is not halting with this, then you will have the propagation always, but you see we have not defined such tiles here, because we have defined tiles to take the transitions up to, you know, the steps which are less than t. So, I will not have tiles if it is not halting. Whenever it comes to the halting state, then I can propagate till whatever is the appropriate number that I have. So, we will give this kind of tiling for that. So, k we will fix. So, now if I take S is equal to k t plus 2, once I reach to halting state, then I have a mechanism to propagate using halting state further and give the tiling. Okay. So, let me give a note on it, let us look at. So, at the first place, the tile, you know, we are fixing with a blank and Q naught, and then you are fixing all these are blank cells. So, this is what is the first configuration. Okay. And in the second configuration, whatever is the state updated, so second configuration will be given appropriate tiling like this and so on. Whenever it is halting with within t steps, so that means when I get a halting state here, because this transition you will be giving with till less than t, okay, this kind of tiles. And once I get a halting configuration, then up to t plus 2 steps, you know, we will have, you know, we will be able to propagate. So, this is what one more step we are considering, and we have already given tiles of this form. so that you know in 0 you will be starting with all this information with all this blank, and then you update the transition. You will be able to update the transitions up to a certain mark. That means, up to t plus 1 by t plus 1 tiling you will be able to, okay, with respect to the number of transition if it is not halting. Okay. After that, these two particular things you will not be able to, because so till this point you can go with, if you have halting state here, then you will be able to propagate to this. So, this you can go k less than or equal to t. Example, if we go, then you can recommend to have, you know, t plus 2 by t plus 2 tiling with this system. Now, you understand, given a non-deterministic machine M, and if it halts within t steps, that means if it is in n 1, now these tiles, because the configurations are essentially shown as tiles. So, in this tiling system, it will have t plus 2 by t plus 2, it is s is equal to t plus 2, right, s by s tiling you will have, so that will be in t. Now, in this tiling system, if you have an s by s tiling, that is s is equal to t plus 2, what is the meaning of that? Because what are the tiles that we have created up to t by t plus 1 by t plus 2 t plus 1 tiling, if the machine is not halting anyway you will get, but you will not be able to get the last row. That means, the t plus 1th step, that particular row you are not going to get, because we have not given tiles for that purpose. Okay. So, if the machine is not halting, then you will not be able to, and if the machine halts before that, before that many steps, I get a halting state and I will be able to propagate that, and so that I will have s by s tiling. So, given M, if it is not halting, I mean when I do not have s by s tiling, that means there will be at least one row free, and thus the corresponding x is not in n 1. If I have a tiling, that means the machine is halting within t steps, so that the string x is in n 1. Okay. Is this construction clear? So, I will just recap once again. What we are trying to do here is, we are trying to reduce n 1 to t in polynomial time. Okay. So, this reduction, how are we doing? Take a string, if it is of the form m, this a non-deterministic machine m, and at the rate 1 t, we are trying to give tiling system. This will have t plus 2 by t plus 2 tiling and vice versa. That is how we are producing. So, whatever the configurations that you have, that means the tape cells that you have, each cell may be treated as a tile, as in case of tiling problem, and each of this configuration can be seen as the tape can be seen as each cell as tile, and the configurations that you are propagating will be seen as a tiling. Now, if the string x is in n 1, that means the non-deterministic machine m halts within t steps, then you know once I fix, that is t plus 2 by t plus 2, within this t steps I will be reaching the halting configuration and with the state h, and we are giving a tile which can propagate in the halting state up to one more or you know up to the steps up to the tiling t plus 2 by t plus 2 tiling, all right. And if the machine is not halting, that means you will have infinite propagation. So, at the stage, you know, for t plus 1 by t plus 1 tiling, you will get the t plus 1 by t plus 1 tiling, but the last row you cannot get, because you do not have a tile which can propagate up to t plus 2 by t plus 2 size, because all these tiles, this tile, these are all given with for the steps up to t. Okay. So, this is also given up to t, and with all this vertical horizontal constraints, but whereas this I will give to fill up to one more, because through this halting state. Thus, we can have this kind of what is called tiling if and only if x is in n 1, all right. And now, what you have to observe, that this kind of construction is possible in polynomial time with respect to the input size. Okay. Because what are the tiles we are constructing here? Because m is encoded here, that is part of the input, and you see how many tiles that we are giving. So, with respect to each symbol and this, we are giving this kind of tiles, And with respect to the number of transitions, we are giving this kind of tiles with for every A, B in sigma, okay, and all this. So, again the number of transitions and the number of symbols of sigma and this k, you know, whatever that we are choosing, they are all finitely many. So, you will have finitely many tiles with respect to the input parameter, okay. And similarly, this case, these are all finitely many tiles. So, this tiling system is, you know, is in polynomial with respect to the given input size. And you can argue now that the what is called the tiling system can be created in polynomial time with respect to the given input parameter. So, that you can observe that n 1 is less than or equal to p t. So, that bounded tiling problem is NP complete. Okay. So, now what I will do, I will give some more NP complete problems in this lineup, and we can nicely cross check the and learn like how to show a given problem is NP complete. There are several variants, as I had mentioned, of this n naught. Maybe we have talked about n 1 and many other, and we have reduced n 1 to this tiling problem. Now, I will, as I had mentioned in this lectures, I will also give, you know, the first NP complete problem which was established, so called the satisfiability problem, that was the first NP complete problem which was established by Stephen Cook. Okay. So, the Cook's theorem says that satisfiability problem is NP complete. Okay. So, I will give a proof for Cook's theorem in these lectures. Okay. First, I will talk about the problem, I will introduce the problem, and then I will say like how, what is the approach that we would have to show that this is NP complete. So, the Boolean satisfiability, you all know about this Boolean formulae. But let me just reiterate here, let x1, x2, xn be a finite set of Boolean variables, because you know Boolean formulae, they are defined over a set of a finite set of variables. Okay. So, using the following rules recursively, Boolean formulae over x is defined recursively as follows. Each x I from this set is a formula, this is known as atomic formula, and if f and g are formulae, then so are this f bar, this one may write negation f, okay. This is also a Boolean formula f r g. Okay. This is what is called disjunction, right, and then conjunction of two formulae is also a formula. And of course, people might even say this is also a Boolean formula, if f then g, that can be. So, this connective is also included in some of the definitions, but anyway we will consider just this much. Okay. So, you know all the Boolean formulae which can be defined recursively using these two rules, right. So, that means, any formula by finitely many applications of these two rules, whatever that you get, we call them as Boolean formulae. If you want to include this kind of connectives in all that, that you can extend this definition and have the Boolean formula. Okay. Now, a formula, a Boolean formula is said to be satisfiable if there is a truth assignment which gives the truth value true to the formula. You know the truth assignment, right. So, in the formula f, the variables from x 1, x 2, x n, whatever they are available with respect to that, you know how to give for the formula truth value, because for x 1, x 2, x n, the respective values when you are given, the possibilities of truth values from 0 and 1, you can have, you know, 2 power n here, 2 power n combinations, and with respect to that f, what is the truth value that it will receive, you know, for all these things 0, say for example, for this 1 likewise. So, there are 2 power n possibilities of truth assignments, and at each assignment, what is the value that f is receiving. Okay. So, these are the values, say for example, 1, 0, whatever that which we are going to get. As you know, for atomic formulae, whatever that you are assigning, for negation of x, x I, if you are giving 0 here, negation of x I you are giving 1, and similarly, for f or g, you know, the truth tables, like for f and g, if you know the truth values, you know for f or g this truth table you are aware of, and similarly for f and g for conjunction, right. So, these truth tables are known to you, so that you know for a given formula you know what are the what are the possibilities of truth values. Now, we say a formula is said to be satisfiable if there is a truth assignment at least one row against to which you should get you know value 1 for f. Okay. A formula is said to be satisfiable if there is a truth assignment which gives the truth value true to the formula. Okay. Now, what is satisfiability problem we consider, what is the variant of the satisfiability problem? That is, I am not worried to give any arbitrary formula, I take a formula in CNF, conjective normal form. What is conjective normal form? Conjective normal form of a formula is of the form, it is conjunction of disjunction of laterals. Now, what is a lateral? Lateral is an atomic formula, lateral is an atomic formula or its negation. That means, in this present context what I have x is equal to x 1 x 2 x n, okay? And now, lateral is either x I or negation x I. Okay? So, these are called laterals. Now, a conjunction of disjunction of laterals, I mean you know formula should be of the form, say for example, x 1 or x 2 you know or x 3 bar and say x 1 bar or x 3 and so, this is you see this is disjunction. So, conjunction of disjunction of laterals. So, a formula which is in this form we call it a CNF. Now, satisfiability problem is given a Boolean formula in its conjunctive normal form, whether or not the formula is satisfiable. Now, I give you in a specific format, conjunctive normal form. Now, we have to verify, we have to cross check whether the given formula is satisfiable or not. That problem is called satisfy problem, satisfiability problem. Let me write it as SAT. Now, Cook's theorem states that this problem, satisfiability problem, is NP complete. Okay. What do I suggest now in the routine manner, because we are doing how to establish a problem is NP in NP. To prove SAT is NP complete, of course, you have to observe that SAT is in NP, and then we have to observe that SAT is NP hard. What do I suggest? You establish SAT is in NP, because given a certificate which in a polynomial time, you should have a polynomial time addition procedure to verify that the given formula is satisfiable or not. Okay. So, that means essentially in our procedure, you have to identify a polynomially balanced language which can be decided in polynomial time. Okay. So, you do that part as an exercise. I will in the next lecture, I will give a proof, or you know I will give a reduction from already established NP complete languages to the satisfiability problem, so that we can establish that SAT is NP hard. So, in this classroom, since we have already established a few languages, some of the variants of N naught also one can work out as classroom exercises. So, I will make use of these things only to establish that satisfiability is NP complete to prove this Cook's theorem in the next lecture. Thank you.